Start by turning on the oscilloscope, then turn on the function generator. Put it on square wave. Set it on 500 Hz range and somewhere to frequency between 300 and 400 Hz should be fine. Set the mode to channel A and the trigger to internal. If you don't see a signal, try adjusting the trigger level. Adjust the time sweep to get more or fewer periods. Now adjust the time sweep so that we've basically just got a single charging of the capacitor. Observe the shape of the curve as the capacitor charges. When I go to a higher frequency, it has the same shape. It's just that it's charging and discharging more often. We are using the square wave on the function generator to mimic a charging and discharging switch. I will put the function generator back on the 500 Hz range. Adjust the time per division so that we can clearly see a couple periods and see where the highest and lowest voltages are. Adjust the output voltage on the function generator and the vertical positioning on the volts per division knob of channel A to get the signal where the top and bottom are at convenient places for measuring. It's 6 divisions between the bottom and top of the signal. I want to measure how long it takes the capacitor to get halfway from the bottom to the top, so I'll stretch out the time to make a more accurate measurement. I'm trying to stretch out the signal as much as I can so I can get an accurate time measure. I go try to find as stretched a position as I can where it changes by 3 divisions. I may have to adjust the trigger a little bit too between the different settings. I go up to where it's halfway between the top and bottom, and I count how many divisions over that is. Try to count as accurately as possible. Then I multiply times the time per division setting on the time sweep to get how long it was to charge halfway. This time is a measure of how long it takes the capacitor to charge halfway. We will call this time T1/2. Your lab will tell you the relationship between T1/2 and the circuit time constant represented by the letter tau. Your lab will also tell you how the time constant relates to the resistance and the capacitance of the circuit. The time constant determined from T1/2 that we got from the oscilloscope and from the resistance and capacitance of the components in the circuit should be relatively close to the same value. If they are not close to the same value, remeasure T1/2 on the oscilloscope and double check your resistance and capacitance values. Adjust the time sweep and the function generator so that you can display several periods at once. Adjust the volts per division on channel A. You may have to adjust the trigger as well so that it only takes up about half the screen vertically. And then use the vertical adjust knob to move the signal to the top half of the screen. Now I'm going to switch the mode to dual so we can display both channel A and channel B on the screen. Move channel B down and adjust the time per division to match the setting for channel A. If I measure the voltage of the function generator relative to its own ground, I measure to the left in this diagram. But the oscilloscope measures the voltage of the capacitor and the voltage of the resistor relative to its own ground. So the capacitor voltage is measured to the left, and the resistor voltage is measured to the right. We want to measure the resistor and capacitor voltages both in the same direction so that we can add them. Fortunately, there's a fix for this. The oscilloscope can invert channel B so the signal is displayed in the opposite direction. Then, both the capacitor and resistor voltage are measured in the same direction that the function generator voltage was measured. The channel B vertical position knob can be pulled out to invert the channel, and then you'll have to reposition the signal. Notice that when the capacitor starts to discharge, there's a large negative voltage on the resistor. And when the capacitor charges, there's a large positive voltage on the resistor. But each time as the capacitor gets charged or discharged, the voltage on the resistor goes to zero. Basically, it's measuring how much current is going through the resistor. If we were to add these two signals together, we should get the voltage across the function generator, which is a square wave. This is really easy to do with this oscilloscope. You simply change the mode to add. Make sure that both volt per division settings are the same. The reason we may not get a square wave when we add them together is there may be other resistances and inductances and capacitances in our circuit that we're not taking into account. These could be contained in the oscilloscope and the function generator.